Hi everybody, my name is Beck and welcome back to my channel. Today we are talking about how to efficiently express at work. Remember, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. I will be posting these sorts of tips and tricks on parenting hacks every Friday at 7 p.m. Today I am celebrating that I'm officially not needing to express at work anymore. Zoe has dropped all day feeds, which means I am down to 7 a.m. and 7 p.m. and that is it. I am excited because it now means I get to go to work to work, and it's time where I can socialize with my peers and just feel like Beck. I have now done the expressing at work situation 2 times. I did it first with Amira and then with Zoe, and I have learned a lot from my mistakes and the things that went well, and that is what I am sharing with you today. Now, with Amira, I expressed at work for about 2 months, and with Zoe, I've expressed for about 1.5 months. The reason why I'm stopping is not because my milk supply diminished in any way, shape, or form. It is simply because I am at that stage where I have reached my personal goal of giving up breastfeeding. And so this was just the journey. I have been expressing with Zoe quite frequently over her lifespan, not just when I went back to work. There were many a time I just wanted to check that I did have milk and so I would pump. And then other times my Mick and I would go out for a date and I'd come home and express milk to store for later. Going back to work was not the cause for me of giving up breastfeeding. It was just the right time for us and our family. To start with, I have this bag. Now this bag is so good because it actually came with a breast pump. The brand that we got this time around for Zoe is the Mandela brand. And that is because when I was trying to express with Amira, I had an Avent brand and it was a single pump, and it was great for the time and season that we were in our lives. We didn't really have a lot of money, we didn't really have a lot of experience when it came to pumping, but I personally found that a dual pump was the best way to go. So this time around, when we found out that we were pregnant with Zoe, we saved up and we got a Mandela dual breast pump because that's what they used in the hospitals when I was in there with Amira, and so we thought we'd get one for home. But inside my bag are these things. So first things first is the dual breast pump, and these are so good. The difference I found when expressing at work having one pump versus two is when you have one pump, you are missing a letdown, which means that you can't really get as much milk as fast as if you do have two and you're just pumping simultaneously, catching the letdowns from both breasts at the same time. So this is in my bag as a must. The other thing that's clearly going to be in my bag is my breast pump, and this has the two plugs for the two breast pumps. And next that is always in my bag is the charger. Now, one time, actually multiple times, let's be honest, I would sit down to pump at work and my battery was flat. So thankfully I had this. There is a PowerPoint right next to my desk, and so I would plug it in and pump. So lifesaver, always have it in your bag if you know you're gonna express, because you never know how much batteries on your pump. You could be super organized, but I'm definitely not that organized. Now, something that is different this time around that I didn't have with Amira and I didn't really know about was Mandela comes with these two little holders, and they are so good because there is that meme going around at the moment that no one cries over spilt milk unless it's breast milk. This is a fail-safe way of making sure that you don't accidentally spill your milk. So the containers sit in these little holder things and they're super stable, which is fantastic because yeah, you don't really want to be expressing it and then accidentally losing all the milk that you got. It is liquid gold for a reason. Also in my bag, I have lids for the containers. The next item I'm gonna show you, I didn't have with Amira. It is a little bit expensive, but I feel like it's totally worth it. Whether you're a first time mom or you have other kids, I know it's come in so handy with Amira and toilet training and needing to have free arms. And this is the breastfeeding bra. Now this is super handy because you put it on, you put your pump in, and you've got two hands free. And I know that I am a bit time poor, and when I'm pumping at work, it is also my morning tea break. So I put that on, I'm able to multitask and make the most out of my break, get milk for Zoe, and feed myself, look after my needs so that I can work the rest of the day. If you are currently expressing, I definitely, with all my heart, recommend getting one of these bras because it makes pumping so much easier and you can relax. You're not having to sit there and getting muscle cramps and feeling like that time is just useless. Highly recommend this. Last but not least, I have my little esky bag, which is so helpful because the freezer in our little mini staff room wasn't working, and there were many a time where I would have to transfer my breast milk into the public staff room freezer, and this is just a really discreet way of doing it. Inside my little esky, I generally have 2 ice bricks and then just a little one that I can kind of wrap around to make sure that it definitely doesn't defrost. I generally put my breast milk straight into the freezer when I'm pumping because it means that if something does go horribly wrong in transit and it takes longer to get home, or something's happened and it starts to de-thaw so that I can use it that night, rather than if it was just cold breast milk and something happens and then it gets into room temperature, and that's when the shelf life of that breast milk diminishes so quickly. So my personal little tip would be to freeze your breast milk after you have pumped it, so that way you do have more time just in case anything happens that you didn't plan for. Once everything is laid out on my desk, there's a couple of things that I do to make sure that my environment is ideal for pumping. The last thing you want to be doing is stressing out, because that is when your milk supply will just not be as efficient as you need it to be. So I close the door to my office, I clearly lock it to make sure that it is a safe environment. Then I make sure that all my equipment is laid out on the table. This means I can visually see that I do have everything and that I'm not pumping and then when I get to the end freaking out because I can't find something. So that's just something that I do to make sure that it is as effortless and smoothless as it could possibly be. Then once everything is done, I make sure that my lunch is within easy access, because like I said, I'm a bit time poor when it comes to expressing at work, so I have to express as well as eating at the same time. So that way I set myself up and I start to pump. The next thing I do is put some headphones on, and this is because I like to kind of zone out and be at peace. Because like I said, the last thing you want to be doing is causing stress, and you don't want to be stressed or anxious or anything when you are pumping. And so usually what I listen to is some music that makes me calm. Otherwise, I actually go through videos of the girls mucking around and playing and being cute and giggling, because I just have this theory that it's going to release those endorphins that I would be getting when feeding Zoe. And so yeah, that's kind of my little method of doing it. Don't know if it works in general, but the placebo effect definitely works. And then I always make sure that I have photos on hand of Zoe, because I just want to be reminding myself the reason why I'm doing it, because sometimes it can be really isolating. At the moment, I'm using one break to express, and then one break I have a duty. And so I actually don't get any me time during my work day. I'm actually really happy that that season of expressing at work has come to an end. But while I was doing it for the last month and a half, I did make sure that during that expressing time, I was relaxed, I was organized, I had everything, and then I had the girls to just remind me the whole reason why I was doing it was for her. So that's definitely how I kind of get things set up. I also at work have a container that I put my water in, and I use Milton to sanitize it after washing it out with warm soapy water. I wrap it up in a tea towel, put it back into my bag, and bring it home. If I don't have time to do this, then I just wrap it in the tea towel, bring it home, and then I do the cleaning here at home. The other thing that I have found so handy when you are expressing, and this was learning from both expressing with Amira and expressing with Zoe, is make sure when you do go back to work, you have a routine of when you do your feeding. That way, rather than waiting for a letdown, I know in my job career as a teacher, I really only have morning tea and lunch breaks to work with. So I kind of like made sure in that lead up of going back to work that I was feeding Zoe in those times, so that when I was having to express at work, it wasn't missing it. Because like I said in my breastfeeding video last week, this all works off muscle memory. And so the times that you're feeding at home are the times that you pump at work. So leading up to going back to work, I fed Zoe at 11 and fed her at 3. And that is the reason why the 3 o'clock feed was the first to drop in my weaning process. So then I just had to express at 11, and then closer towards the end I was kind of expressing around 11:10 or 11:20 or half 11, and so that way I was kind of drawing it out a little bit more, so that now I'm to the stage where I don't even have to express at 11 because I'm not getting a letdown. So definitely my little tip for you, if you are going to be expressing at work, is train your body to have letdowns at feeding times, and that way you know when to pump and when to get the most milk out. And that way when you are at home, it's still the same rhythm and routine. If you are currently expressing or have expressed at work, please comment below on the tips and tricks that have worked for you. Because this parenting gig doesn't come with a rule book, we only have each other. So if you've liked this video, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to hit subscribe and tap that bell so you get notified when we upload next. And I'll see you in the next video.